baptized. And you know everybody, you know the one that a lot of signs. And what's time for him to be baptized?
Generation.
Yeah. He said he was life.
Yes, and that life
became, he
the light.
Yes.
And anyone that follows the light, that means.
Mm.
Say, I have said it.
Mm.
You are God.
You are God.
But because you don't believe it,
that's right.
You shall die like a man. Imagine a God dying like a man.
That's right.
That is why cancer is killing us.
Right.
Because you have not discovered who you are.
Hey. That's right.
God the Father came, did his own. Said, I've shown you the promise.
Mm.
He used Abraham to act everything about him. And used Jesus. Are you aware that where Abraham wanted to crucify, sacrifice, I think, was the same place Jesus was crucified?
Mm.
Kai.
Oh, read your Bible.
That's right. That's right.
You are deep.
When you search the scriptures, you have searched from cover to cover.
Mm.
Genesis to Revelation for 6 times. Mm. You will understand. So God only used that. That's what this evening presents, shadow drama.
Yes, shadow, that's right.
Act.
Drama.
To act the real thing. What does that mean? It means if you don't understand it in the spirit, go to the Old Testament and see the shadow. You start getting picture.
That's right.
Abraham represented God. Do you know that there's only one person in this whole creation that is not a son of God?
Mm.
Abraham. He's not a son of God. No, he's a friend of God.
Mm.
He has his territory, Abraham goes.
Mm.
And that's what we call God heaven. Okay. Abraham is in charge. And Jesus came and said, if you are not Abraham's seed, you will not see the kingdom.
That's right.
Okay. God is a very, he said, Abraham is my friend. So I'm giving him the earth. And any of the Bible says none of them went to heaven. Until Jesus died.
Mm. Mm.
And there was darkness 3 days, and Jesus went to heaven, released all of them.
Released all of them.
And they went.
That's right.
The Bible says those that were dead, we are released.
Yes.
Mm. Am I making sense?
Yes.
God the Father came and did his own.
Mm-hmm.
And he now said, okay, it would be foolishness to me if God was saying, you know, some you think God is a monster, he's our best friend.
Yes.
He's our Father. Until you see him that way, you don't really. And they enjoy him.
Mm.
See, the foolishness of me, they don't know what is love. Mm-hmm. They can't repent.
Mm-hmm.
I have to enter in a cloth called Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
He now went on another assignment after God the Father Jehovah.
Mm-hmm.
Are you getting the point? Mm-hmm. The problem we have is that we believe that it was Jesus that wanted to be the Christ.
Mm-hmm.
He said, no, it was Jehovah that wanted to be Jesus. The Bible said, you know, he made the choices for everything.
Mm.
Jesus made the choices for everything.
Mm.
He said, none of us will come to heaven and see parents.
Mm.
But he chose that he will be in heaven. And the Bible says, he's interceding, he's crying. He's the only one crying here. Interceding on our behalf because he doesn't have testimony until we make it to heaven.
Mm. Yes, yes, oh, yes.
Church, help me today. When you have this understanding, you just give him the free hand. Let me say this before I. You see, if you be doing this a year, once a year, you know heaven is real. You know hell is real. Until we understand that God's main character is to hide things, we will not understand
that. That's right.
I can never come and just show you things clearly.
No, we will hide it for you.
Proverbs 25.
That's right. But there's the glory of God.
It's the glory of God to hide.
To hide the matter.
And he does it so that he will use it to bring out kings. Kings are preached.
Right.
So what does that mean? You will think you're doing with God, but with
God. He will judge you for you.
That's the way he does it with God. That is why you cannot understand him. Jesus came and started doing the same thing. He came today, he preached, I am bread.
That's right.
He came the other day, he said, I am water. He came the other day, he said, you eat my flesh and blood. The people said, you are
not.
Which one are you?
He said, which one are you? He said, no, tell us. What must we do so that we will serve you very well? He said, believe the man I have said to you. Believe that your pastor. And he came in Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 14 and 15. He said, when you come back, you backslide in Israel. I will give you a pastor with understanding and knowledge. He will take you to where you're going. The same Bible that says, I come with peace, I come
that's
with
right.
The same Bible says, Jesus also said, I came with salt.
That's right.
Matthew 10, 34. How will you understand things like that? God is hiding matters. It's not faith. Christianity is not. Why am I saying this? If you don't understand it, but he has revealed it to those. If you check, you don't understand the spirit, go back to the Old Testament. You start seeing shadows.
Yes.
Because what it means acting. Then Jesus came and said, come, let me show you the
visual.
He said, look at the way to access the promise. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to the Father, Jehovah. And in the same scripture where he said, no man can come to the Father except through me. Remember that the 3 verse 20 of Exodus says, no man shall see me and live.
Yes.
But Jesus said, if you follow me, you will see the Father and live. Shalom over. Just remember what he says.
Yes.
Don't play with this. Give God these 3 days. And what you do at the beginning of every year will determine how successful you are.
That's right.
Heaven is real. Hell is real. Come to a place like this. I want to encourage those on the media. Next year, this morning we are talking about 200 and something. It's nothing. But you will use it to buy your life, buy the future of your children. The money, you know, and sometimes I just don't understand. I was hearing my members, the kind of job I'm doing now was the job they were doing when I was getting nothing. When I see what is in the job, I ask my wife, is it the kind of money these people were making? And yet they will come to me for a prayer point. Pastor, pray for me. I don't know what I'm using my money for. This type of money, the devil is eating your money. It's not, it's foolishness. You see the kind of money every member, pay time, they will not pay time, do all this. But if the first, if this person buy gym, all their friends will buy gym, they will be paying $1,000. I was asking some of my colleagues, why do you go and take brand new car and start paying? He said, Pastor, if you don't have it all, when they call you for a job, he said, if I call to tell you the kind of car, the car I started with, although they've given me like 6 cars in Australia here. Sometimes if I give it to you to ride, you will not ride it.
Hey,
you say it would be no, it would be the smell it to you.
Wow.
But I have used those cars. No one day has it stopped me on the way. Until I made my choice. Because the car, what sustains your car? What sustains your car is not the mechanical or the mechanism. It is you, the he that is in you. That's so I am the part.
The he that is in you.
I said I'm not ready. That one I've been using to be paying every month, every week, fortnight. I've been saving it. Australians, they have already gotten their home. We Africans, we need a home here in Nigeria. Double.
Hey.
Am I making sense?
You are making sense.
Otherwise, these my children would never visit Nigeria. They will run out from Nigeria. Say, what am I doing there today? Man, I'm going to put something that will make them. I'm going to build something. I'll build university. And they will be the chancellors. And let me see how they will be living there without looking after them.
That's true.
That university. I will build it and make it will be so attractive when they remember, I've already planted a church in Malaysia. I've planted a church in Australia. The next place is Israel. Why am I doing it? Because of the university. Malaysia be doing to one of the pastors that started the church. He built a university. Nigeria cannot fund a university, but we can give scholarship. Imagine the next 50 years, the whole of my community will go to school with scholarship. If Australia gives 20 scholarship,
Israel give 5 scholarships, Malaysia give 10 scholarships every year. And my own children, I've been telling them every day, I say, if I build this university, it is you people that will sponsor my village people, community. You'll be giving scholarships. I say, my daughter, if more than 10 every year. I don't know what you're using your money for. You are the chancellor there. What will you be using them? So what am I doing? I'm trying to draw the potential in them before even they start doing something.
That's right.
I don't know what that is. And foolish ones among us here, we are competing. Nah, she's riding Jeep. What? I came to Australia before and she's riding Jeep.
Hey.
She will put up all these clothes, 1,000.
Or
you throw away your money. Old age is coming.
That's
When you will not have strength to look after but those who help will say, no, we will look after you. Without you, we wouldn't have been anybody.
Yes,
are you getting the point?
Yes.
Invest in people.
Let me tell you, if God wanted you to be Australian, your color would have been Australian color. Just not fooling yourself. God only asks you to come and learn from what they have so that you go and also help your people. Christianity is not first for us to go to heaven. It's for reconciliation, for us to reconcile God's people back to
Himself.
I get the point.
Yes.
He sent Jesus. Jesus came and showed us the way. And He finished. Jesus finished and then went back. Whose turn is it now? The manifestation of the promise, which is the Holy Spirit.
The seal of the promise.
I want to encourage as many that are listening to me from the media. Locate this place, get the address. Come and add life to your life.
Oh.
Stop spending your money on things that will not last. Come and invest on things that will last forever.
Yes.
Imagine what is going to happen. So many people have already. Somebody called me aside and said, Pastor Joseph, don't behave like these people. A season like this, Australian Day, they'll go and get another plastic, which is another credit card.
Another plastic.
Another credit card. They will just throw away what is still very good in their houses to buy just to. Say, don't follow them. It's because they are seeing things on the platter of God. But don't forget where you know when I was living, my father called me 3 times. I said, Papa, I have had you 3 times. He said, look at where you came out from, but don't forget it. And not deny, I can't forget it.
Yes.
My children, they were born here, thank God for their life. They don't eat the back of bread. Go in my fridge, it's packed for me. The back, you know, the up and the down. My children don't eat it. I said, I can't throw it away. Front and back. But you don't say, but I told them one day you eat it. So that when you are belly food, the one you still have money, you send it to those that doesn't have.
That's
because that's the only thing that will not leave you. That's the only thing that will not leave you. Do you know when we died? When we got born again. Mm-hmm. Your Bible?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. 1 Corinthians 11:10.
Mm-hmm.
He said, talking to those. That have already come to the end of their war. So you are not going to die again. You die when you don't have anything that is representing you on earth. The whole side is not dead. Sweet, who knows what they are not dead? Even when Jesus was talking, he said, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, and God of Jacob. I'm not talking about God of the dead. I'm talking about God of the living. So Jesus was entering to say, Abraham did not die. You might think I'm telling you a story, but I started preaching because I like laying foundation before I go into. Because if I don't lay foundation, you'll be confused in my teaching.
This is
because I teach pastors. Crowds cannot understand me. I teach. That's why I'm into leadership. So
when the crowd doesn't understand, they go to my leader, they will be able to break it down. So, where I'm going, this is a conference, it will be wickedness for me, knowing what you guys have suffered, knowing how much it takes to organize something like this. And I'll come here and preach and go. You know, preaching will shape the things around you. But teaching will produce Christ.
That's right.
So I'm not going to produce Christ in us. So after this meeting, now how many of us knew that this is no more the era of Jehovah? This is no more the era of Jesus.
That's right. The era of Jesus.
We are the era of the manifested.
That's right.
You know when Jesus was so powerful. And the people came and said, hey, yeah, man, we want to go. He said, shut up. My era has ended. And my era must end speedily. So that the man, the era was shut up. Little to the eye. Seven steps.
Hi.
Process. It's a process.